We are looking at class 10, chapter 5, information representation method HTML1. The solution are for certain questions which have come in the examination. These are unsolved examination questions which have come in various examination in various sessions. First is, what is an attribute in HTML? See, HTML is based on tags. All this tag do is to inform the web browser that you have to show the content which is inside in certain way. But if you want to show the additional properties or additional information, there are attributes inside this tag. So the attribute provide additional information about the HTML tag. For instance, if you want to specify a background color of a web page, you need to use this background attribute. This is a property with this body tag. Body tag is a tag. Now you are adding this additional information to this tag. How would you preview the changes made in an HTML code without closing the HTML document in the text editor? Now you have a text editor. You don't want to close this text editor, but still you want to see the preview. What you have changed should be seen. So what you have to do is, this is your web browser. Just refresh it. Just refresh it or reload it. So you can preview the changes by refreshing the HTML page. Name two common graphic file formats that most browsers recognize. There are various the file formats which are being specially made or developed for web views only. For example, PNG, GIF, and various others are there. And more prominent is JPG also, though it was not designed for web, but still this finds a very popular place in the web community. So JPG and GIF, because we are being asked. So JPG, joint photographer group, this PNG for portable network group. So this, there are various, two of these are JPG and GIF, and graphic information format, interchange format, sorry. They are two common file formats that most browsers recognize. Which heading element gives the most prominent heading? From H1, this is the prominent heading, we go up to H6. H6 is the last one. So H1 gives the most prominent heading. Next is, expand the following tags used in HTML. HR is for horizontal rule. A rule or a line will be there in 3D. If you want to make it in 2D, you have to use no shade. You can also give the size. Sub is for subscript. Sub is for subscript. Subscript means, if you want to write H2O, this 2 is the subscript of H. So you have to use this subscript. UL is for unordered list. You want a list not in the format this one, but say in bullet or in square form. For this, you have to use this unordered list. A is for anchor. Anchor. This is the hyperlinking stuff. You will give the links inside this. So HR stands for horizontal rule, sub for subscript, unordered list, UL, A for anchor. Distinguish between container and empty tags. Container tags and empty tags have one difference. Container needs the end tag also, starting an end tag. Like, I'll give you an example. Empty tags means those tags which they don't require any closing tag. So the difference between these two are, container tag, it refers to the tag contains an opening as well as a closing tag. While empty tag, it refers to a tag that contains only an opening tag. For example, HTML. It requires an end HTML, body tag, any tag you want, because these are few. You can just name them, like BR, like your say IMG, like your HR. They don't require, you don't find any BR like this. You will not find it. There is no point or there is no provision of giving this /HR. They don't require it. Write code to insert an image, picture.gif, on web page and center align it in the web browser. So we will use the IMG, we'll use the SRC as picture.gif, and we'll keep it inside a tag which is center. So what we have to do here is, come to body, use this center tag to center this picture, and then in this picture, if you want to show this picture IMG, then source you have to give like this. If there is some path, you have to give the path also. Find errors in the following HTML code segment. Rewrite the code and underline the correction made. So I'll underline and rewrite here itself. This is UL, unordered list. See, this unordered list is ending with an OL, which is not possible. So what you have to do here is, I'm changing it here only. I've underlined it. You have to use it UL. Inside this, we have li tag. But li is not ended. We need an li with forward slash. Same here, same here. So the list tags are not closed properly. This one. And the closing tag of a list should be UL, not OL. Compare home page and website. See, a website is just a folder with various web page on a web server that is accessed using HTTP through www. Say a website has 100 pages. Which page is going to come in front of you when you ask for this website? It has to be some page. That page is home page. Basic page, index.html, or the page which is the basic page, home page. So a website is a collection of web page, while a home page is the main page of a website. How can you insert horizontal line in a web page? You have to use this HR tag, horizontal rule. Rule means line. So one can insert horizontal line in web page by using HR tag. How are comments inserted in HTML code? Comment are inserted like this. Use this with exclamation, then two dash. Write anything here that will be commented, means web browser is not going to even look at it. It will be ignored. Then you have to close using two dash and an angle bracket. So comments are written inside an opening and closing. This is an opening, this is a closing. Any comment written as a any content which is written as a comment is not displayed by the web browser. What is the extension of HTML code file? It can be .htm. It can be .html. So the extension of HTML code file is .html. How do you display text in the title bar of a browser? For that you have title, title, and end with the title, title. So you can display text in the title bar of a browser using this title tag. How can the font size of a single line on a web page be changed? For that you use this font tag. So the font size of a single line on a web page can be changed using this font tag, or you can use the heading level. And in this font, you have to, between this font, you have to give this single line. Distinguish between P tag and BR tag. Basically, P and BR has no connection. P is for showing the formatted text in the paragraph. BR is for creating a white space, that is the enter, new line. So the difference between BR and P tags is that BR tag is used to insert a line break in a web page, while this P tag is used to mark a block of text as a paragraph or separate your text into different paragraphs. So this P tag not only allows you to represent the text in the paragraph format, but also enables you to format the paragraph text. One more difference is P is the container tag, BR is the empty tag. Why do we insert comment in HTML document even though they are not displayed on a web page? So whenever you are doing programming, are you a developer or related to programming, then when you come after a week of holiday and you see the same code, you will not be able to understand so instantly. But if you have certain line which defines it, maybe it is in the form of comment, you will be able to easily find out or tell that, okay, this is what this code is doing. So the comments are meant for developers and programmers to understand the code. They are not displayed in the web browser. What do you mean by the term source code of the current page viewed in web browser? The source code in HTML code of the current page viewed is the web browser. So source code is of that, means HTML code of that particular web page. So these were few very short questions which are being asked in examination. So I hope that you'll practice these kind of stuff. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.